wasted money could mean the end of your company if you're not doing it correctly. By the way, if you want the system that we're covering in this video as a free checklist, grab the link in the description. You can have a PDF of everything we talked about. On this channel, we've talked a lot about experimentation. I even named one of my companies after it, Experiment 27, because experimentation in the early stages of growing and starting a business is huge to figure out what's gonna make you money, what's gonna go find customers. But as you evolve, as an entrepreneur, something else becomes much more important than experimentation, and that is optimization. I've been talking to a lot of coaching clients recently, which if you want to grab a coaching call one-on-one with me, you can do that at the link below. These are people that have a business already and they're generating revenue, and maybe they're 2, 3, 4, 5 years in and want to add cold email as a new channel. And that's great. It's something we've done a lot of. It is something we specialize at, both with consulting, and we teach it in the course. We talk about it and do it for people at X27 Marketing. So cold email is a channel that I'm very comfortable with, but a lot of the time I'm not recommending cold email to our consulting clients. And that is because of this principle, which is optimization over exploration. What that means is, if you've been running a business for a while, it's more important for you to get more business out of your current channels, to squeeze the maximum amount of juice from your current channels, than it is to find new experimental channels. And that's what I wanted to talk about in this video. I'll give you a step-by-step process for how you should be allocating your marketing budget and how you should be thinking about client generation for your business. The main takeaway is growing and optimizing the spots where you already make money is more valuable than finding new channels. Here's the step-by-step process. One, you want to find the top customer channels for your business, meaning not lead generation channels, not the channels that are generating the most email signups for you, not the channels that are generating the most conversations with your sales team, but what is the number one channel for your business that is generating new clients? For most agencies, 70 to 80% of their clients come from referrals. And that's the first channel I would tackle. We did this recently with a Magento agency, and just by going back to their current customers, they were able to get $100,000 in new business in 30 days. There's a lot of revenue to be gleaned from whatever that top channel is. For us at Experiment 27, we have two main channels that are basically even. One is YouTube, which generates a lot of leads, but not as many sales as we would like. And then cold email, which generates a lot of leads, meetings, and sales. So for us, we optimize the crap out of our cold emails. We make sure our open rates are high. We make sure our lead quality is high. Our response rates are high. Our back and forths, like, we're owning that entire channel. And then number two, second priority, is moving over to YouTube, because that's our second highest channel. So now we make sure that everyone that comes in from our YouTube channel from these videos goes through a funnel and is converting at the right number. We're doing all of this, right? Our top two channels, we're doing all of this over finding a new channel, experimenting with Facebook ads or doing any of that stuff. So that's number one, find the top customer channels for your business. Identify what those are. Then number two, grow those using 80% of your resources. If you have $100,000 per year to spend on marketing and you're us at Experiment 27, I would take $80,000 of that, split it in half. $40,000 a year goes towards cold email. $40,000 a year goes towards the YouTube channel. And that leaves $20,000, which I'll talk about in a second, where that money should go. And that is 80% of your marketing budget allocated to the channel that generates revenue for you. And those are just the two channels that work for us. If your top revenue generation channel is events, 80% of your revenue should go to events. The only reason ours is split in half between YouTube and cold email is because it's almost a 50-50 perfect split, which is cool that we have two. Most companies don't even have one good revenue generation channel. But if it's events, then 80% of your marketing budget is going to you at events. Maybe that's speaking gigs, maybe it's hustling up new business, hiring a salesperson to go for you, whatever it is. If it's Facebook ads, then that's what you're focusing on. SEO, whatever that main thing is. Referrals, spending 40 grand on a full-time person to just drum up referrals and take customers out to lunch to get new recommendations might be a good investment channel for you. So that's what you're doing with the main chunk of your budget, because that's where you know you're gonna make money. I know for a fact, if I put 80 grand into YouTube and cold email, we can make 800. We can make a 10X on that. So it only makes sense for me to invest in those two, but I reserve 20% of the budget for point three, which is experiment with 20% of the other resources. Experimentation is the exploration of new channels. So 20% of your marketing budget could go to somebody like X27 to handle your cold emails. It could go to Facebook ads. It could go to SEO, podcast interviews, whatever. experiment around. With that money, I would also try to optimize for number of at-bats, which is a baseball term. At-bats meaning, let's say you have 100 grand of marketing budget total. You've spent 80,000 on your current channels that you know work, and that leaves 20,000 remaining. One thing you could do, and I was just talking to a consulting client the other day who did this, is spend all 20 grand on one experiment. Don't do that. What you wanna do instead is optimize for number of at-bats. $20,000 could be 10 $2,000 experiments. Maybe $2,000 goes to cold email. Maybe it's hiring me and then using the rest of the money to hire somebody to implement. So I'm leading and then they're doing it. It might be writing articles, whatever. You wanna split that up. And the reason why you wanna split it up is, let's say 1 in 10 marketing experiments will lead to a positive ROI for you. And that positive ROI means a 10 times increase in marketing spend. If it's 1 in 10, you wanna make sure you have at least 10 marketing experiments going, because otherwise you might just have wasted that money. And in business, wasted money could mean the end of your company if you're not doing it correctly. So you split that remaining 20,000 across 10 experiments. And hopefully, if you do it right, one of those experiments makes the money back and can become one of these other channels that generates consistent revenue for your business. Then you move them over to the 80% marketing budget. Your marketing budget increases because your revenue increases, and you continue to grow the company in a vicious cycle. Now, you might be wondering, why not focus 100% of the marketing budget on things that are proven to generate an ROI for your business after you do this analysis? And the reason you want to experiment is because channels die. I've experienced this before with Quora. At one of our agency clients a couple of years ago, answering Quora questions was our second most powerful lead generation channel, until all of a sudden it wasn't. So if we were investing resources into Quora, which we were, and not investing resources into exploring new channels, we might have lost 30, 40% of our revenue if we lost that channel. So you constantly want to be reinvesting and experimenting, even when you're extremely confident that these channels are working. So for instance, at Experiment 27, YouTube is working amazingly well. Cold email is working amazingly well, as it should, because we're a cold email company, come on. But we're still trying Facebook ads. Div is spinning up our Facebook ad campaigns right now, testing some of our highest performing email campaigns as Facebook ads. We're experimenting on Instagram, although our Instagram right now is not business content. It's mostly, you know, personal content. But we were for a while experimenting with Instagram ads. We are booking on podcasts still. We're doing a little bit of live event stuff and a lot of collabs. So there's a lot of experimentation going on. So that's what I want to hit on. Takeaways from this video: don't be afraid to reinvest in the marketing channels that are working for you. Honestly, I would take a pay cut, do whatever you have to, just start growing your revenue as much as possible, because you can always cut that. And then at the same time, keep experimenting with new revenue generation channels. And that's how you make sure that you continually grow and continue to succeed in business. Have you been trying a bunch of different marketing tactics and nothing's working? I would love to work with you one-on-one to figure out exactly what's wrong. Whether you're using cold email to get billion-dollar clients on board, like I've done for most of the Fortune 500 for our clients, or you're using YouTube videos — we have over 23,000 subs, so I know something about that — or sales strategy, sold millions and millions of dollars in business-to-business transactions. If you're dealing with issues in any of those, I would love to have a one-on-one consulting call with you. You can get more info on that at experiment27.com/consulting. Thanks for watching. I'm Alex Berman. Subscribe to this channel for more business content like this video to encourage this type of content in the future. And leave a comment below. What are you optimizing for right now? What is your top revenue generation channel? And what are you going to do now to grow that? Thanks for watching.